That truth is that motion has two components. It has a horizontal and a vertical component. And those two components are completely independent. What do I mean by independent? I mean that we can break a two-dimensional motion problem into two separate one-dimensional motion problems. And this is an amazing tool. Well, we've already shown how in one dimension, if we're, for example, dropping a ball, at the instant when we drop the ball, well, it has no velocity, not quite yet. 1 second later, it's picked up some velocity. It picks up that much again in the second second, and again, it picks up the same amount in the third. And we can represent that pictorially with pictures like this. Now, what if instead of dropping the ball, we throw it to the side? What kind of arrows are we going to draw now? The instant the ball is released, it only has horizontal velocity. That's from you throwing it. I said before that these components are completely independent. So that means after 1 second, this horizontal component, well, it doesn't change. It keeps going to the right. And just like in the one-dimensional problem before, it picks up some speed, going downwards. In fact, it picks up the same amount of vertical speed that it would have had we just dropped the ball. After 2 seconds, horizontal component does not change, but the vertical gets twice as long. And after 3 seconds, the vertical grows again, and the horizontal stays the same. Now, this is a sort of strange picture here. Is this ball moving to the right, or is it moving down, or is it moving in some other direction? Which of these arrows best describes the direction of the ball's motion at this point in time? And it's a guess, so don't worry if you're wrong.